The kingdom Vijayanagara covered a large part of peninsular India from south of Krishna River to Rameshwaram, including Tamil and Kerala. Vijayanagara reached zenith of prosperity and greatness. It said that gold and pearls were sold on streets like vegetables in Vijayanagara. The Sultan to the north of Vijayanagara united and attacked Vijayanagara army in a war known as the Battle of Talikota. The defeat of the Vijayanagara Empire at Talikota, followed by the subsequent destruction and looting of their capital, led to the slow decline, and a lot of families were migrated. Out from Vijayanagara. None of them didn't realize that this war going to bring the incarnation of Prakhlada, a devotee of Vishnu. Yes, wait for the story to get folded, how this war bringing the peace for the entire world through Sri Raghavendra.
Timmanna Bhatta and Gopikamba were concerned that they did not have a boy child. Having thought much about it, they approached their family guru. The knowledgeable guru looked at the horoscopes of both the parents and observed something unique in them. He later asked them to visit Tirupati and seek the blessings of Sri Venkateshwara. He also told them that they will bear a boy child who will be an extraordinary intellect and also will help cure many problems in the world.
Sri Timanna Bhatta and Srimati Gopikamba visited Tirupati and performed very rigorous seva to the Lord with utmost devotion and diligence. And the couple was blessed with a son.
Vande Brindavana Charam Vallabhi Jana Vallabham Jayanti Sambhavam Dama Vaijayanti Vibhushanam.
Blessed with a son. When Gopikamba was pregnant, her face was very bright. She liked the color saffron and she desired to listen only to the holy scriptures. These were the indications that a divine child is to be born. This divine child was born on Thursday, Shukla Navami of Falguna month in 1595. When the moon was in Mrigashirsha Nakshatra at Bhuvanagari near present-day Chidambaram in Tamil Nadu. The face of this newborn baby was full of radiance and brightness. As a gratitude to Lord Sri Venkateshwara, he was named Venkatnatha, and in future he became Swami Raghavendra Tirtha.
Raghavendra Swamiji, as a young child, was very inquisitive and a fast learner. He was once discussing about the syllable Om with his father.
Adisaya Mandiram Om Adi Bhagavan Om Indiran Kavasam Meenu Mandiram Om Indiran Kavasam Meesanin Ragasiyam Om Enu Mandiram Om.
Young Raghavendra Swami asks his father, how can it be possible that the magnificent knowledge of all the gods and the philosophies are defined by Om? Father explained that Om comprises of three parts, A, U and Ma. It encompasses the three loka. It also encompasses the Purna or completeness, and also encompasses shunya or nothing. This is the supreme sound, which in a single syllable is a mantra in itself. Om holds a special status in our philosophy.
At a very young age, Swamiji's father, Sri Timanna Bhatt, introduced him to the art of music through Veena and started teaching him lessons every day.
Saraswati Namastopyam Varade Kamarupini Vidyarambam Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada.
And started teaching him lessons every day. Swamiji did not attend any formal school as a kid and was homeschooled by his father. Being very smart and talented, Swamiji picked up the Veena lessons very soon. He not only mastered it, but used to teach it to others as well when he grew up. His passion for Veena music continued throughout his life.
The young Raghavendra Swami was raised by his sister and her husband Lakshmi Narayana Achar. He studied at Lakshmi Narayana Achar Gurukulam in Kaveripatnam, Tamil Nadu, and was an outstanding student there. Lakshmi Narayana Achar performed Raghavendra Swami's Upanayana when he was around 8 years old. When a boy is born, there are 16 samskaras that must be performed in his life. The most important samskara is Upanayana. Upanayana means getting a step closer to God. Takes the oath of how he is going to lead his entire life, being respectful, trustworthy, and learn about God in depth. This is when a boy becomes a brahmachari and is ready to enter the next big step in his life.
Lakshmi Narayanacharya, please accept my humble obeisances. This is my brother-in-law, Venkatanatha.
Oh Guru, please accept my obeisances. I am Venkatanatha.
I have passed all my knowledge to him and I believe Venkatanatha is much more capable and only an extremely knowledgeable Guru like you can guide him furthermore. Please accept him as your disciple, O Guru.
Oh esteemed Guru, as mentioned by my Pratama Guru, my brother-in-law Lakshmanacharya, I will be extremely fortunate if you would accept me as your disciple and give me an opportunity to serve you.
I shall accept you as my disciple, Venkatanatham. Venkatanatha, you are truly blessed that during this short Adhyayana period, you have mastered Sriman Nyayasudha.
It's all due to Lord Rama's and your mercy.
Venkatanatha, your Parimala Tippani is unparalleled to anything that has been written before. Henceforth, you will be known as Parimalacharya. With this being said, I have passed down all my known knowledge. And I believe it is time for you to advance in your spiritual life under the guidance of Sri Sudhindra Tirtha.
Oh Guru, I shall obey your instructions and proceed.
Hariyane Nisidani Nisha Avagano Arusha Hariyane Nisidani Nisha
Raghavendra Swami had a profound faith and knowledge in Madhva Siddhanta. He learned Madhva philosophy from his teacher at his Gurukula. He was well versed with the philosophy and had mastered Sarvamula Grantha authored by Sri Purna Prajna Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya preached the Dvaita or duality philosophy, according to which Atma is different from Paramatma. These are two unchanging realities. He preached Panchabheda Mahasatya. Any two material objects are not the same, any two souls are not the same, any material object and the soul is not same, material object and God are not the same, soul and God are not the same too. Raghavendra Swami was an adherent devotee of Sri Mula Ramadevaru and Panchamukhi Pranadevaru.
Guru Raghavendra Rindari Manave Hari Sarvottama Vayu Jivottama Sharanim Bevani Sharanim Bevani Podreye Kalyani Sharanim Bevani Vagabhimani Varabrahmani Sundaraveni Sucharitrani Sharanim.
Raghavendra Swami excelled in many fields such as Purva Mimamsa, which is reflection or critical investigation with the focus on Vedic texts, Vyakarna, which is grammar, Vedas, Veena, Sangeeta, which is music, and Nyaya, which is law. Raghavendra Swami's expertise in Purva Mimamsa and Vyakarna is evident from his works on Vyasatirtha's Tatparya Chandrika, which runs up to 18,000 stanzas. Sri Sudhindra Tirtha recognized Raghavendra Swami's excellence at a young age and encouraged him.
You had a long debate today and your victory in the debate was well deserved. Venkatnatha, while your victory in the debate was not unexpected, I'm impressed by your Purva Mimamsa skills. I'm more surprised by your scholarship in grammar, your profound knowledge, and your rare debating skills. I'm impressed with the thoroughness of your notes as well as your interpretation of my lessons. Henceforth, you shall be known as Mahabhashya Venkatnathacharya. Venkatnatha, you come from a family skilled in music. Your great-grandfather, Krishna Bhatta, tutored the king of Vijayanagara kingdom, Krishnadevaraya. And your father, Timmana Bhatta, was a skilled musician as well. With your expertise in playing the Veena, you shall be known as Veena Venkat Bhatta. Venkatnatha, you are the chosen one with the six vidyas needed for spiritual enlightenment. You have mastered Purva Mimamsa. You are an expert at Vyakarana. You are well versed in the Vedas. Your Veena and Sangeet skills are second to none. And your interpretation and delivery of Nyaya is just. You will, one day, be revered as one of the greatest holy saints this world has ever seen, with millions of followers for generations to come. After finishing his studies, young Venkatnatha returned from Madurai. His sister and brother-in-law arranged his marriage with a very virtuous lady, Saraswati Bai. She was an orphan who hailed from a good family. Saraswati Bai proved to be the ideal wife for Venkatnatha.
Nadya Shri Haripada Pankaja Bhuva Kurvantu No Mangalam Sulagna Savadhana Sumuhurta Savadhana लक्ष्मी नारायण ध्यान सावधान
Lord Sri Ramachandra appeared in my dream and has instructed me that he wanted to see you as the sannyasi in the matha offering worship to him. Venkatanatha, shocked and modestly, bowed to Sudhindra Tirtharu. Oh Guru, how can I even think of accepting such a position? Sudhindra Tirtharu, smiling. I am pleased with your humbleness, Venkatanatha. This is Lord's desire. He will be guiding us at each and every step. Venkatanatha, deeply in thoughts. I'm really sorry, O Guru, pardon me. I will not be able to abandon Grihastha Ashrama and accept sannyasa as I have a young wife and son who are my responsibility and I cannot disown them. O Venkatanatha, Lord has chosen you with a purpose. Please perform the Upanayana of your son and come back and take sannyasa. And he thinks about his wife Saraswati and his son. In the early hours prior to dawn, he sees a light in his dream and Goddess Saraswati appears in front of him. O Venkatanatha, please hear your Guru's word and accept sannyasa to uphold the tenets of Sri Hari's and Lord Madhva's philosophy. Venkatanatha wakes up from his dream, shocked and says, Goddess Saraswati appeared in my dream and I now fully understand Sri Hari's desire. His command is something that I cannot ignore. It is very clear now which path I am going to choose. After fulfilling my Grihastha duty of conducting Upanayanam of my son, I accept the sannyasa. Venkatanatha and Sri Sudhindra Tirtharu go to Tanjavur. Venkatanatha undergoes all the rituals. Sudhindra Tirtharu says, Oh, Venkatanatha, from now on you have been initiated as a sannyasi and henceforth you will be known as Raghavendra Tirtha. You will be in charge of the matha and will be worshipping ancient Sri Moolarama idols.
Raghavendra Swami was not only a man of miracles, but also a writer of exceptional ability. He was a brilliant scholar and an orator. He brought alive the classic scriptures, texts, and sacred testaments of Hindu Madhva legacy through his writings.
ಕರಸಂಜಾತಾ ನಿಮ್ಮಯ ಚರಣದಿ ನಾನು ವಿನೀತ ಭಕ್ತರ ಹೃದಯ
ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೂಸಿಡ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ ಹೀಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಧ್ವಾ ಪ್ಯಾಂಥಿಯನ್ ದಟ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಧ್ವ ಮಥಾಂಬೋಧಿ ಚಂದ್ರ meaning the moon shining from the ocean of Madhva Siddhanta. His language is simple and the flow of thought like a wave. He is credited with having written more than 40 works, including commentaries on Vedas, Upanishads, Vyasaraja's Chandrika and Prakaranas of Madhvacharya. Nyaya Sudha Parimala is one of the most popular commentaries on Nyaya Sudha of Sri Jayatirtha. It is because of this that Rayaru is called Parimalacharya. Inspired by goddess Saraswati, he composed the classical exposition called Chandrika Prakash. During his stay in Udupi, for a year, he wrote Nyaya Muktavali, which is believed to provide a holistic understanding and Madhva philosophy. He dedicated his writings Chandrika Prakash, Nyaya Muktavali, and Sudha Parimala to Udupi Sri Krishna.
Raghavendra Bhajanamrita Saviyuta Raghavendra Bhajanamrita Saviyuta Ihadalu Paradalu Nanu Vinita.
One of the miracles of Raghavendra Swami was the story of Neerina Venkanna. Venkanna was a pious and humble Brahmin whose day-to-day job was to fill water for the puja of Lord Sri Rama. He was hence named Neerina Venkanna, or Venkanna's, whose job is to fill the water. Once he happens to know that Sri Raghavendra Swami is visiting the ashram and he insisted upon him for darshana. That Sri Raghavendra Swami is visiting the ashram and he insisted upon him for darshana. Raghavendra Swami met him and noticed that he is looking for some help. Venkanna asked Guru Raghavendra if he can get moksha. Raghavendra Swami looked at him and asked him to perform Sandhya Vandana and come near Agni Kunda. Raghavendra Swami asked him to jump into the Agni Kunda, praying to Lord Sri Rama. Venkanna readily jumped in. For a surprise, Lord Sri Rama himself came and saved him and hugged him in blessing. This is one of the many miracles which we can see by Sri Raghavendra Swami.
पदाहृताभ्यां नानाविमोहाति निवारिकाभ्यां नमज्जनाभीष्टततिप्रताभ्यां नमो नमः श्री गुरुपादुकाभ्यां नमो नमः श्री गुरुपादुकाभ्यां
Sri Raghavendra Swami is considered to be magnanimous and benevolent. Countless devotees of his testified to the miracles he has performed. Once, two kids were playing kavade game, chaukabara. As the game goes on, one of the smaller kids put the kavade in his mouth and swallowed it. After some time, the kid lost a consciousness and fell down without any movement. People got together and concerned too. Rayaru was traveling and passing by the same village. As people have heard about Rayaru, they brought the kid to him.
Mandala khandamandanam prinayamo vasudevam srishti samharali.
Rayaru chanted Veda mantras and put few drops of Tirtha, the sacred water, in the mouth of the kid. The small child, who was lying down unconsciously, got up as if he was waking from normal sleep. Everyone around and who witnessed this got astonished with Rayaru's abilities. Om Shri Raghavendraya Namaha.
Siddhi Masood Khan, the Nawab of Adoni, was informed that Guru Raghavendra Swami had arrived. Initially, the Nawab refuses to meet the saint, but finally agrees to meet Raghavendra Swami and test the saint's powers. The Nawab, along with his queen and son, meet Raghavendra Swami and offer a basket covered with a cloth.
मुसलमान दोरे राघवेंद्रा तट्टेली भोजन राघवेंद्रा मुसलमान दोरे राघवेंद्रा तट्टेली भोजन राघवेंद्रा बट्टेयु मुच्चिरे राघवेंद्रा
Swami with his divine power senses that the basket is laden with meat below the cloth. He sprinkles holy water on the cloth and asks the Nawab to lift the cloth. The Nawab is surprised to see the basket that was laden with meat has turned into fruits. The Nawab apologizes to Raghavendra Swami and salutes him with a Sashtanga Namaskara and accepts him as the Guru. He also regrets for his behavior and asks Guru to punish him.
Teethava pokshi se Raghavendra, tatteli phala pushpa Raghavendra, jaya jaya vive Raghavendra, bhava bhaya nashaka Raghavendra, jaya jaya vive Raghavendra, भव भय नाशक राघवेंद्र
श्री गुरु गणे व्हाट इज द रीजन फॉर आवर ट्रैवल टू दिस प्लेस
वत्स योगींद्र तीर्थ वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू ऑब्जर्व विरोधीकृत संवत्सर चातुर्मास्य हियर
व्हाट अ सेरीन एंड ब्यूटीफुल लोकेशन ऑन द बैंक ऑफ दिस तुंगभद्रा रिवर श्री गणे What is the historical significance of this place?
This is the very spot where we, in our previous avatara as Sri Prahalada, did Yajna and Yagas. Because of this reason, we asked the Nawab to gift us this village.
Oh, who was Sri Prahalada's Kshetra Devata present in the Yajna Kunda during those Yagas?
The Kshetra Devata of this place is Sri Durga Devi. Who is also known as Sri Manchalamma. Sri protects the people around this village. We will pray to Sri Manchalamma and get her permission and divine blessings before entering into Vrindavana.
Om Namo Namo Lokajanani नारायण मनोहारिणी चतुरानन वरजननी दैत्य संहारिणी खलकुलदमनी लोककल्याणी भक्तजन चिंतामणि कमलासने कमले माते
वत्सा प्रहलादा यू रिमेंबर्ड योर मदर नाउ व्हाई डिड यू कॉल मी पुत्रा व्हेन यू हैव द ब्लेसिंग एंड ओडनाट ऑफ माय लॉर्ड व्हाट कैन आई डू फॉर यू माय सन
ओ माय मदर दुर्गा व्हाई दिस विट देवी यू रिसाइड इन द हार्ट ऑफ माय लॉर्ड And you have no separation from the Almighty. I'm so blessed to have your darshana while Lord Brahma and Rudra await such a sight of you.
You have already done enough sadhana during Prahlada Avatara. What can I bless you with when the Lord is already so pleased with you?
Mother Manchalamma, I want to enter Sashareera Vrindavana in this place and bless my devotees all across the globe for the next 700 years. please bless me so I can pass on the boons of Laukika and Alaukika Jnana, Bhakti, Vairagya and Sampattu to my devotees.
Tathastu, Putra. As a symbol of my grace, here, you take the mesha and mastaka and install them in front of your Mahadwara. I will protect your devotees from all the evil forces by always guarding them. This place will be known as Mantralaya, providing Mantra Siddhi to your devotees.
Dhanyosmi, Mate, Dhanyosmi. I will reside in the Vrindavana and pray your Lord.
Vatsa, this place will become very popular and will be a focal point for Sanatana Dharma Karya. You will be known as Kali Yuga Kamadhenu and Kalpavriksha to your devotees. I hope your devotees will remember me also.
Mata, I will ensure my devotees take your darshana and blessings first before they get mine. Namo Namaha, Mate. Namo Namaha.
On the day of Vrindavana Pravesha, Rayaru went about his daily rituals, bathed in the Tungabhadra, prayed to his beloved Moolarama one last time, and performed all other puja. He then proceeded to give his final discourse. His disciples and devotees were heartbroken, as this was the last time they would be blessed to hear a discourse from Rayaru in person.
Shri Raghavendra Sakala Pratata Swapada Kanjadvai Vakpi Madbeha Agadri Sambedhana Dushri Vajraha Kshama Surendro Vatumam Sadayam Shri Raghavendra.
As he made his way towards the Vrindavana, Rayaru appeared calm and blessed devotees along the way.
Mishtapradome Satatam Saboyat Bhavyaswarupo Bhavadukkatula Sangagnicharyasukadairyashali Samasta Dushta Grahani Grahesho Duratyayo
Kare Raghavendra Yake Mukanadyo Guruvini Yake Mukanadyo Yendigadaru Ninna Pondi.
Just before entering the Vrindavana, Rayaru raised his hands to bless the assembled crowd and asked people to be righteous and follow the path of Dharma always.
Asankhyanattama punya sangha vilasat prakhyata punyavaha dustapatraya nashano bhuvimaha vandhya supatra prado venga swanga samrido brahma.
ಏಕೆ ಬೃಂದಾವನದಿ ನೆಲೆಸಿರುವೆ ಗುರುವೆ ಶ್ರೀಕಾಂತನೊಲಿಸಿದುದು ಸಾಕಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲೆಂದು ಏಕಾಂತ ಬಯಸಿದೆಯ ಶ್ರೀರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ. ಏಕೆ ಬೃಂದ
Governor of Madras is contemplating enacting a recently established law to abolish all imam lands. In doing so, the government must take away all the land belonging to the Matha. However, the local people have been making representations to the government. The governor has asked Thomas Munro to inquire into the matter and make an appropriate recommendation.
I am here at the behest of the Governor of Madras to learn about the history of Mantralaya and the significance of this matter before making a recommendation.
Welcome to Mantralaya, Thomas. It's a pleasure to meet you again. You may not know, but I remember us being classmates in Krita Yuga, where you knew me as Prahlada. During Krita Yuga, I performed a large yajna at this spot, sanctifying it forever. Then in Dwapar Yuga, when Arjuna was fighting Anusalva, Anusalva's chariot was positioned over the Yajna Kunda used by me. That made Anusalva invincible. Lord Krishna then guided Arjuna to move his chariot back enough to make Anusalva move from the spot and lost the battle immediately. Such is the power of the spot on which I had performed this yajna. The sanctity of this place must be preserved for generations to come, and hence I request that these lands not be taken away. Thomas, here, take some mantrakshate for you and your assistants.
Rairu, you have enlightened me about the historical sanctity of the place and why the land should not be taken away. I will recommend that the British Empire should not consider taking away the lands of the Mata, given the auspiciousness of the Mata, its historical significance, and the higher power it represents.
ಸಾಸಿರಸಾಲೆ ಗ್ರಾಮ ಶಿಲೆಗಳ ಶಿರದಲ್ಲಿ ಧರಿಸಿಹ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರರ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರರ ಬೃಂದಾವನ.
We all know that Rayar Mantrakshate and Padodaka are very powerful. Let us hear one of the miracle of Rayar Mantrakshate and Padodaka. Few years back, a lady who was leading a normal life one day unfortunately got possessed by an evil spirit, because of which her health got ruined and she started losing her loved ones. Lady's husband, who was watching her suffering helplessly, one day took her to Mantralaya to seek blessings from our beloved Guru Raghavendra Swami, who is a great devotee of Sri Hari. By the power of Mantrakshate and Padodaka and the blessings of Raghavendra Swami, the lady was able to get rid of an evil spirit and now leading a normal, healthy and a happy life. Raghavendra Swami has helped many devotees suffering from evil spirits. Even now, the power of Mantrakshate and Padodaka is helping many who are suffering in life. Jai Shri Raghavendra Namaha.
Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Mam Rakshabho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Mam Rakshabho. Ajnananashaya, Vijnanapurnaya, Sujnanadatre, Namaste Guru. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Anandarupaya, Nandavaja, Shri Padambhojabhaje, Namaste Guru. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Ishta Pradhanena, Kashta Prahanena, Shishta Stuta, Shri Padambhojabho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Ide Bhavat Pada Pato Jamadhyaya, Bhuyo Vibhuyo, Vaya Pahi Bho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya, Pahi Prabho. Ugram Pishachani Kamdravai, Pashu Sokyam Janana, Karo Shishabho. Shri Raghavendraya, Shri Raghavendraya,